The story of Texas music begins with the first Texas musician of notable distinction. He was an American composer and the pianist who introduced ragtime music to American society. He would later be dubbed the King of Ragtime for his many ragtime compositions. At the turn of the 20th century, he was one of the most popular musicians in America. Joplin disappeared one day in 1917 and was never heard from again. Scott Joplin was born in the country in 1867, just outside of Texarkana, Texas. His father was an ex-slave from North Carolina, and his mother, a freeborn black woman from Kentucky. He received most of his serious music education from Julius Weiss, a music professor who had immigrated to the United States from Germany. He tutored the young Joplin until he was 16 years old. Joplin's first big music break came when he was in Chicago for the World's Fair in 1893. Unable to play inside the fairgrounds because of his race, Joplin played the smaller clubs outside the fairgrounds where he introduced his ragtime music to American audiences. By 1897, Joplin's ragtime had become a national craze. He moved to Sedalia, Missouri in 1894, where he published his first and most famous composition, Maple Leaf Rag, which brought him fame and a steady income for life. He moved to St. Louis in 1901, where he continued to compose and publish his music. During his short career, he wrote 44 original ragtime pieces, one ragtime ballet, and two operas. In 1907, he went to New York City to find a producer for his latest opera. While there in New York City, he disappeared one day. His disappearance remained a mystery for some 50 years until being solved in 1974. It was discovered that in 1917, Joplin was picked up by the police after being found incoherent and walking the streets. He was taken to a mental ward where he was committed and later died there 3 months later at the age of 49. Unable to ascertain his identity, he was buried at John Doe in a pauper cemetery in an unmarked grave in New Jersey. After his grave was discovered in 1974, a marker was placed there later that year. This next video features Scott Joplin's most famous popular song, The Entertainer.